other side.
My goodness, I can talk again. Oh, oil my arms, please. Oil my elbows.
Yes, sir. Did that hurt?
No, it feels wonderful. I've held that axe up for ages.
Oh my goodness, how did you ever get like this?
Well, when I was flesh and blood like it, like you, I fell in love with a munchkin maiden whose mother hated me. So, to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the wicked witch of the west to put an evil spell on my axe. But when I went to chop down a tree, I chopped off my leg instead.
Chopped your leg off?
Well, that's terrible.
But by good fortune, I know a wonderful tinsmith who made me a new leg, almost as good as the old one. And back I went to work. This time, I swung my axe again, and dang it, if I didn't chop off the other leg.
You should have got a new axe.
I guess you're right, but I got me a new leg instead. And back I went to work.
Well, you sure were persistent.
This time, I chopped off both my arms.
My goodness!
Now, I can see how you could chop off one arm, but how did you manage to chop off the other one?
I already told you, my axe was enchanted.
Now, you see that, Dorothy? If I had a brain, I could have worked that one out for myself.
But the last time I swung my axe was the worst time of all.
Oh, I do not want to hear this.
What happened?
I split myself. Right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
So the tinsmith made me a new head and body, but on my way home, I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and I rusted solid.
Oh, it just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been here ever since.
Oh, you're perfect now.
My neck, can you get my neck? Perfect. Bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead. Bang on it.
Beautiful. What an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith never gave me a heart.
No heart?
No heart.
Oh.
And as long as I have no heart, I'll never be able to love my munchkin baby ever again.
Oh. Oh, please don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rust again.
I used to carve her name into every tree.
You can say that again.
Oh, the smith gave me tin ribs, but forgot to put a heart inside. When a man's an empty cap, he should be on his mettle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding the dark. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart.